a miracle and a mystery. You are the Redeemer. This morning we celebrate that you are the resurrected one. And just like when a forest fire scorches the earth down to the ground, in you we have hope that it is only a matter of time before green grass shoots up out of the earth, new life reaching for the sun. Teach us this day what resurrection means as we celebrate it. That when we are lost, you show us the way home. That when we are wounded, you heal us. That when we have fallen short, you forgive us. That when we are hungry, you feed us, and when we are blind, you restore our sight. Because you are the bondage breaker, you are the one who frees and heals us. And this morning, we say, hallelujah, you are risen, and in you, we are risen too. So accept our praise and worship this morning as our hearts overflow with gratitude and with joy for who you are and who we are in you. It is in the name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior, that we pray and sing and rise. Amen.
177, He is Lord. Sweet chorus, He is Lord. They were running together, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and was the first to arrive at the tomb. Bending down to take a look, he saw the linen cloths lying there, but he didn't go in. Following him, Simon Peter entered the tomb and saw the linen cloths lying there. He also saw the face cloth that had been on Jesus' head. It wasn't with the other clothes, but was folded up in its own place. Then the other disciple, the one who arrived at the tomb first, also went inside. He saw and believed. They didn't yet understand the scripture that Jesus must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to the place where they were staying. Mary stood outside near the tomb, crying. As she cried, she bent down to look into the tomb. She saw two angels dressed in white, seated where the body of Jesus had been, one at the head and one at the foot. The angels asked her, "Woman, why are you crying?" She replied, "They have taken away my Lord, and I don't know where they have put him." As soon as she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she didn't know it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you crying? Who are you looking for?" Thinking it was the gardener, she replied, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have put him, and I will get him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Aramaic, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Don't hold on to me, for I haven't yet gone up to my Father. Go to my brothers and sisters and tell them, I'm going up to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene left and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord." Then she told them what he had said to her. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. This morning we're living the resurrection, amen?
Amen.
Throughout Lent, by the way, which officially ended when you woke up this morning, and that does not mean that you automatically break all the rules that you neatly put away, okay? It's just a signal for us that Christ is alive. Praise the Lord, Christ is alive. And throughout Lent, we have focused on this necessary rending of our hearts so that we can live the promises of Christ. The revealing of the promise that Christ the Lord is risen. And so we shout out, hallelujah. Let me hear you say it, friends.
Hallelujah.
You know, this is revealing the power of God. There is no exuberance too loud. No expression too excessive. This is the day that we share and shout together, Christ is alive, Christ is risen. Look at us, Lord. Here we are celebrating you. You are risen for us as the sun begins to peek over. We didn't get to do this last year, friends, but here we are. It's almost as if we're breaking some rules, and that's okay, because that's what our Lord and Savior Jesus did, amen? Opened up the gates for us that we might have everlasting life and everlasting love. But here's what we need to know, that Easter is not a day. Easter is a season. Easter begins today and runs all the way through Pentecost. The joy of Easter needs to sustain us until the Spirit comes on that Pentecost day. But as Easter people, we know the holiness of God, the Spirit of God is with us right now. So we live that every single day of our lives. Amen? We live the resurrection, and we live the power of God, and we live the resurrection. From this point on, we live with resurrection joy. And so what does that look like for us, church? Coming out of our houses. Wearing our masks when we need to. Hugging when we feel that it's right. We become joy seekers. We become seekers of Jesus. From Easter morning to Pentecost, we express our life through the risen Savior. I read this week that a 20th century humorist, Evan Essar, said, "Easter is the only time when it is perfectly safe to put all of our eggs in one basket." This made me look up Evan Essar. Evan Essar, 1899 to 1995, was an American humorist who wrote Essar's Comic Dictionary in 1943, Humorous English in 1961, and 20,000 Quips and Quotes in 1968. That sounds like something Wyatt would need to read, right? He is known for a quote such as, "Statistics, the only science that enables different experts using the same figures to draw different conclusions." Those of you that are scientific might be nodding your head at that, and I think that that might be true. I think it's true about a lot of things, and I think it's especially true about religion. They had some Baptist friends join us briefly this morning. Our friends are singing Glory Hallelujah right around the corner here. We have different religions, but we have this foundational faith. We have different theologies, but it all comes down to this understanding of the resurrection of Jesus. The resurrection is the gospel. Without the resurrection of Jesus, the salvation story is rather incomplete. Jesus died for our sins. Jesus rose to show us God's power over sin and death, and that we rise too. We rise. Above all things, we have victory. And I hope that you can testify to that victory in your life, whatever we need to rise out of and into. We rise to the victory that we feel today on this beautiful, crisp morning. It's peaking, look, just like clockwork. It's working, just like God is every single day. Above all things, we have victory. How do we live in this world, this real world, as those who are fully committed to the promises of Easter? How do we grab hold of this new way of living? You'd be saying, well, it's not a new way of living, Pastor. I've been celebrating Easter for years. But how do we grab hold of the truth that it is? How do we grab hold of this understanding? The resurrection, the death and darkness never wins, that hope always wins, and that hope is alive. Our praise band sings that song, right? Hope is alive, and hope and grace always win. We grab hold, and we call ourselves Easter people. We might be singing that for the next week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, to remind us of living the resurrection means that we are new life people, because God has put new life into us. Grab hold of the Easter promise that Christ is alive in us. And how does the resurrection of Jesus help us today? How does it help you? How does it help me? I believe it's all about this attitude, right? This attitude that makes Easter the celebration that it needs to be, and that attitude that stays with us every single day. As my mama used to say, no more stinking thinking. Stay on the positive side of life. In our gospel reading this morning from John 20, we find a very emotional Mary and then Peter and John arriving at the tomb, and Jesus was gone. And Mary was continuing the work of ritual. Her life was all about ritual. Her sister Martha was the ritualist. But Mary, the way that she was brought up, it was about ritual. And there she was at the tomb early in the morning to wrap Jesus in spices and ointments, purifying his body. But guess what? God had already done that. In Mark's gospel, in Mark 16, verse 3, the women were heading to the tomb, and they were asking along the way, who will roll away the stone from the entrance of the tomb? They needed help, knowing and believing that Jesus has died, and they want to go take care of their master. And John's telling of the resurrection story, Mary arrived to find the stone was already rolled away and the tomb was empty. Can we begin to imagine the emotion? Today we have elation and excitement about it because we know the full story. Mary didn't. The disciples didn't know it. Is resurrection possible? Maybe all that Jesus had taught Mary was floating around in her heart and her mind and her spirit, and she's trying to figure this out. Is resurrection possible? I heard him talk about it. She ran to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved. This is how John referred to himself, and I love that. We should refer to ourselves in that same way, the one that Jesus loves. Say that inside of yourself. Know it. Be bold enough to know that you are loved by Jesus. She found these disciples and she said, and I don't know what kind of attitude she had in this moment, they have taken the Lord from the tomb. Was she shaken? Was she crying? They have taken the Lord from the tomb and we don't know where they have put him. Peter and the other disciple, well, they went to the tomb and they found out what Mary had said was true, and they went back to the upper room pondering with sadness. But Mary stayed at the tomb. What caused Mary to stay? The Spirit of God was upon her. Maybe she didn't even know it, but something caused her to stay at the tomb, and she stayed there. And there was Jesus. His voice, woman, why are you crying? Who are you looking for? And all it took for Mary's countenance to change was to hear the voice of Jesus calling her name, Mary. When you hear the Savior calling your name, your name, and he knows your name. She turned with Rabboni, which means teacher, recognizing the Holy One right there with her. And I feel that Mary was saying in her spirit, teacher, keep on teaching. Teacher, help me to understand. And when I don't understand, give me the faith to believe. She turned toward Jesus. And friends, that's what he's asking us to do today. We've rended our hearts. We repent from our sins and we turn away. We turn into a new direction. We must turn toward Jesus and hear him say our names, calling us, loving us and freeing us. By the Holy Spirit, we hear him and we pray, saying, Lord, keep on teaching us. Teach us to love. Teach us to live. Teach us to rise and help us to run to you like the sun rises each and every morning. God works in our spirits every day to help us to believe. So might we be praying today, Lord, help us to believe in your resurrection. Help us to believe that you have given us victory over sin and death by your life and your death and your resurrection. You created your church. Hello, church. That is us. Over the past year, we have discovered that it doesn't have to be that building on the corner of First and Main or wherever building you go to worship. Christ is in us. Christ is with us. He began as Emmanuel, God with us, and now by the power of resurrection and his Spirit, he is in us and for us.
Amen.
We are church. I've been feeling it for the past couple of weeks that God is breaking something loose. And we need to join that. We need to join, we need to believe, we need to rise. Will we rise? Will we live the resurrection? Will we rise to the promises we receive from Christ? Will we rise to the saving grace? Will we rise to the mercy? Will we rise to forgiveness and offer forgiveness? Will we rise to the peace and the comfort? All of these are the promises. As we rend our hearts, we open our hearts, we find the promises so real, so right, and so true. We return to the empty cross, the empty tomb, and rise as Easter people, new life people. And will we hear Jesus say to us, who are you looking for? Maybe he's saying, what are you looking for? And might he hear us say in return, as well as the entire community, I have seen the risen Savior, because he lives in me today. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Friends, we have the opportunity this morning. Wendy, can I have you help me pass out?
Yep, there it is.
Communion cups around. Easter people, raise come to you this morning in anticipation in our spirit. The stone has rolled away and the tomb empty. The opportunity inside of us, new life experiences that we might live the resurrection. Bless us, Lord, as we receive today the gifts from you, your body that was given for us just a few days ago, made new in heaven today. The blood that you spilled for us that offers us the forgiveness of sins, Lord, we praise you and ask your blessings that as we receive and know that you are inside of us, alive in us, that we may be your hands and feet in the places that we go. Bless us as your Easter people, that we believe the resurrection, that we can hear you calling our name, and that we can share and testify that we have seen you. We praise you, Lord, in this holy moment. Pour your blessings over us in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Good morning.
Thank you so much for coming today.